Why? Why does great songs always have to end? Hello there everybody, this is Getty92 coming at you today with a new episode, and we are gonna go back in time. Yesterday we did a song from Fly By Night from 1975, and the day before that we are still on the first album, and today we will take a look back on the first album, because today we're gonna listen to the 1974 song Take A Friend. Let's get right into it.
No, why?
Why? Why does great songs always have to end? We're gonna talk about this one. I constantly get the feeling, especially since this week we have had some great songs, especially this week. We were primarily only covering the first two albums with The Wash 1974. We've already done Before and After and What You're Doing. Then we had yesterday's video with In the End from the 1975 Fly By Night. And then we went already back to the 1974 Wash song with today's video Take a Friend. And I can't help this list. Like I said before, people frequently ask me how I choose the songs. And I actually found a website that says all 167 songs by Wash ranked from the worst to the best. And we are only here, everybody. We still have to do these songs. Then we have to cover these songs. And then we have to cover these songs. And then these two parts here. These are really special things that I'm gonna show you after we've done all the Wash stuff. But like I said before, I can't help myself. I won't modify the list in any way because I think this is a good list. And if it happens that this whole week takes place with the first album and the second album, I'm primarily okay with that. And if you're okay with that, that's awesome. That's fine. If you don't like the first album, which I, like I said before, I totally understand, I think this week won't be your favorite week of the Getty 92 channel, but I'm not sure. We still have to make a video about Nobody's Hero, Dreamline, and on Sunday, Bravado. And I don't know right now from what kind of like time periods these songs are, but if these songs happen to be one of the first albums and you don't like them, well, you better skip this week. But on the other hand, let's talk about Take a Friend. Take a Friend is a great song, but I think on the same level you have to say that these kind of songs, especially from the first record, you really have to be in the mood, which is a garbage song. We already did that song, In the Mood. If you haven't seen this one, check it out, but it's not worth checking it out because the song is not cool. The first album, you really have to be in the mood to really like these kind of music stuff that Wash put out there on in 1974, because the bass sounds the same as like on any album, the same does with the guitar. There is a huge difference in the drum section, of course there is. It sounds different, but it doesn't sound bad. It actually sounds very good, and it suits every song so far that we've heard so far from the 1974 record. It suits this record perfectly. The biggest difference that I see there are the lyrics. I think the lyrics starting from the second album then, or when we're talking about especially by the Fly By Night album, there really you can listen to some deep tracks. And every song is kind of like a deep track in terms of the meanings of the songs. Until Virtuality and Dog Years came around, but that's another story, you know that. And I'm constantly doing that. This is like of kind of my comedy part in there. Whenever I have something bad to say, I'm gonna throw in Dog Years or Virtuality. So these are like the exceptions. But as for the most part, I think the first album has great lyrics. As from the music that is on that record, and therefore Take a Friend, it's great. It's as great as Before and After or What You're Doing. It just suits the album perfectly. The lyrics are okay in some way, because I know what you guys are looking for here on the Wash Getty 92 channel, which is not a Wash channel. I told you that before. I'm planning to do other stuff too, but I like Wash. I can't help myself, so we still have to do the Daily Dose of Wash. So therefore, guys, I like this song. I like the first album. I have to be honest with you guys. So if you don't like this album, like I said before, you better skip this Getty 92 week for this week at least. And see you guys tomorrow. And tomorrow we're gonna do a song called Nobody's Hero. And I think I've heard this one before. I can't recall in my head how the chorus starts, but I think I've heard this one, and I hope there will be some live music videos in the later episodes, because sometimes I do really miss live music videos. So guys, see you tomorrow with a new episode, and tomorrow we're gonna do Nobody's Hero. And I think I'm everybody's hero. But there will be a difference, especially when I say 1974 was a great year for Russian music. Then I won't be everybody's hero. See you guys tomorrow. Bye.